Wednesday was a pretty big day for presumptive Democratic nominee Joe Biden. In addition to announcing his unity task forces with Bernie Sanders and Bernie Sanders supporters, Joe Biden also did an interview on a show called Good Luck America, which is Snapchat's political show. And during this interview, Joe Biden actually said that he supports and that this country right now needs a federal freeze on mortgage and rent payments. For the duration of this pandemic, Joe Biden announced yesterday that he does in fact support a federal freeze on rent and mortgage payments. That is a huge step forward. That is a huge step forward for this candidate who just a few months ago said that even if the House and Senate passed Medicare for All, he would veto it. You know, this is not exactly a champion of progressive values that we have as the presumptive Democratic nominee, but apparently after just a few weeks of having conversations with people like Bernie Sanders, suddenly this guy changes his mind a little bit. This guy opens his mind a little bit to these hugely progressive ideas like this one of the national moratorium on the rent and mortgage payments. And here's what he had to say. He said, you know, this isn't forgiveness. This isn't just you have to pay it back later. He said, it is forgiveness. He said, not paid later, forgiveness. It is critically important to people who are in the lower income strata. And here's the thing. He also went on to say that some states are not able right now financially to put these plans in place for a rent and mortgage moratorium. So he said what the federal government needs to do is they need to increase their funding to these states who are struggling so that they can, in fact, issue that. He actually, from the sound of it, kind of has a plan in place for this. And if I seemed a little shocked by that, it's because I am, folks. He's thought about this. They've kind of looked at the nuts and bolts of it and said, this is what you would have to do. This is why some states are not currently doing this or why they're not able to do it. And here's what would need to happen in order for they've looked at it. They've actually thought about it. This was not a spur of the moment, Joe Biden talking out of his butt kind of thing. No, he said this because this is something they have put thought into. And that is another good sign. You know, as I have repeatedly said, I'm not a huge fan of Joe Biden. You know, his history is against him. He has a horrible history of lying, of inappropriate behavior with women, some very serious allegations against him that need to be taken seriously and discussed honestly. But this is a good idea. And when somebody has a good idea, we give them credit for it. This is the kind of plan that absolutely needs to happen. You know, if you want Joe Biden, or if you want a progressive, in office, I think at this point, the only way we're going to get that in the president is by pushing somebody to be a progressive. And that's what's going to happen with Joe Biden. So we can either write this guy off and just say to hell with it, everything's going to be horrible, or we can continue to try to pull him to the left. This story to me is proof, not solid proof, not incontrovertible evidence, but it is showing that on some issues, Joe Biden can be pulled to the left. So I'm going to stick in this. I'm going to keep pulling. I'm going to push. I'm going to do everything I can to make this man embrace progressive policies. Even if deep down he hates it, we have an obligation to move this party to the left so that it can benefit as many people as possible.